Well, that was one of the few humorous incidents in Normandy. We were preparing to leave Normandy, and as was our custom, we used slit trenches to go to the bathroom, and we'd filled in those trenches early in the morning that we were leaving. And as we got ready to leave, we looked over and saw a group of French nuns in their normal garb putting flowers on those trenches which had been filled in and mounded over. The dear nuns thought those were fallen soldiers' graves and were putting flowers on our slit trenches. It's very funny, but oddly enough, nobody laughed. Nobody.
And I would imagine that by that time, most of your soldiers had seen real grave sites.
Oh, yes. Many, many real grave sites. And they appreciated so much the goodwill of the nuns that they saw far beyond the humor of the occasion.
And then discussing that, did you have any interaction with the French civilians at that time?
Yes, because they brought us bottles of their fiery liquor. Calvados was the name of it. French, made from apples. It would knock you for a loop, but it was the best thing that we could get in the nature of a beer or wine, and they French graciously shared it with us, and they brought us bread that they'd made, and they were good friends. They were our allies.
And given their condition, obviously here they are stuck in a combat zone, and they obviously were very grateful to have the GIs in their area, to have been liberated.
Yes, they were, and they expressed it in the meager way they could by bringing us wine and bread and potatoes and shared with us the precious foods that they'd been able to keep from the Germans. And they went out of their way to keep us informed, if they could, of any German sympathizers who had been left in the area, and to keep us apprised of any threats to us. And I'll always be grateful to the farm people of the French neighborhoods who came to our rescue and our aid in so many ways.